did you get this car?
About 1961.
1961?
Yeah.
Did they have Burger King back then?
Yeah. I don't think so.
Is all McDonald's still?
Yeah, they had McDonald's. But not many. There wasn't any in Manteca, that's for sure.
Do you know what car lot you bought this off of?
What car lot?
Yeah.
No, I got that from my brother and my dad. It was in a bar. It was in a bought the property over here in French Camp. Sitting in there with two of them. There was two of them, 28 and a 29. This one and a 28 Model A. And it was just sitting there going apart, pieces. So I asked my dad if I could have it, and he said sure.
Did they have car insurance back then?
Yeah, they did. They had car insurance, but you didn't have to have it.
What color was it?
It was black when I got it.
Black?
Yep, everything was black then.
Well, from what the old movies taught me, everything was in black and white.
No, there was a lot of color movies, but this was a black car. That's the color of when I got it, and it was all rusted, and which it is looks now, but it looks a lot better. And it just started working on it one day. Me and my brother and two of my brothers, I guess, or three of them, got to help. One of them was Mickey.
Who? What were the names?
Who?
Who were your brothers' names?
One of my older brothers, and Don and Charles. My Charles was second one, a little older than me, and we just took it out of the field. They were out sitting in the field, and we pulled them out into the field by the shed we had out there, and went to see if we could get it running. It had run before, so we took the front end of the hood off and started working on it. Put the wires on there and all the wires got on six volt batteries, which takes a 6 volt battery. And when was I? Oh, we got it in there and tried to put the juice on it, the batteries and all that, and it started right up and took off. Chung, chung, chung. It really wasn't running that good. And my oldest brother, he decided he wanted to show me how to backfire.
Which brother was it?
Les, my oldest brother, Lester. Les or Mickey. They could call him Mickey. And so what he did is he got it running. And they had the key in there, and he'd turn the key on, and then you would get it running, and he'd turn the key off real fast, and then turn it back off, and it would pop, pow, backfire, and it blew the muffler split wide open, and the old motor, the old engine, never made it. Had to get another battery.
How long have you been working on this car?
Oh, since 19... I was probably 62, somewhere around there, working on it. We'd get it going, and we'd just... smoke coming all over the place. It was really having a good time hollering a truck driver to honk it. He'd honk his horn and wave, and decided I would go Delta College at Stockton, So I got it running so I could drive to Stockton. And so we got in it, and I got in, I was taking it. Boy, doing real good. I'm driving up down. That's when I used to chase trucks on Highway 50, which is El Dorado in Stockton now. But so one time we got up there and my damn thing wouldn't start for me, and it was sitting in the driveway and I wouldn't start. It just grind, wouldn't start. So I had to get out and push it, and I'd try to push it and it would start. Boom! People laughed. They thought that was funny. And my had a little nephew, one of my nephews. He lives in Lodi now.
Which nephew? What was his name?
His name was Leslie Austin Smith. And he went to school in Stockton. And so he was over there by Delta College. So I used to.
What school was it?
The school he was in, I can't remember the name of it. But when I get over there by Delta College, when I get over there by the school, he would pick me. I'd pick him up because I'd have a class for lunch, and then I would pick him up and run over to my brother Mickey's house in Adeline and have lunch. So I would pick him up and drive over to his house and back. And he had fun. The kids would laugh and everybody. All my friends, they used to.
Where was your lunch spot?
In Stockton.
Well, where?
On Mendocino, at Mickey and Aline's house. Going back to when I was getting running good, I used to. All the kids in the neighborhood, most of them, I get out there to take it out to drive it around a little bit, just to drive it around. And those kids would all hang on to the running boards, and they'd be hanging on all over the doors and everything, driving down the road. And, one of my friends, name is Lloyd Marsh. he got smart that, and it didn't have the hood on it, and so we were driving down, and he got smart and he reached over there, and everybody's hanging on, so he hangs on to the spark plug, and when when he reached that thing, it shocked everybody. Everybody bailed out all over the place, took off. And they just laughing up there. It was funny. I just had a lot of fun with it. I had to go to school, and that's when I quit working on it that much. I was driving it, but. And then 62, I decided I wanted to go in the Army. But we had a lot of fun with it. We go try to keep up with everybody, and wow, I get to thinking about it, and what a fun. But so then I went into the Army, and we just parked it in a little shed we had, and still hadn't really did all the work on it. It was all complete, so when I got out of the Army, I got married, we decided, or I decided, we'd take it all apart, the bodies and off and the fenders and everything off of it. So we went about a year or two on that, with working on it, just working on the motors and the rear end and all that parts and stuff and transmission. And happened to get some cash, and so we decided to take it to a shop, and they had to paint it and chrome.
Should have got a racing stripe on it.
It had a stripes on it. It had stripes on it, but they weren't racing cars. Stripes. But so once I got it, I used to drive it all the time. I just can't really think of all the places we used to go. And then racing, but we like racing. Racing them cars.
Should have been home yesterday.